In this video, I will show an example of practical usage of consumer-driven contract testing from a consumer perspective. In my case, the consumer will be in the front end of a real application at an early stage of development. My technical stack will be Angular Framework, Karma Test Runner with Jasmine and Pact.js. We will mock provider, create and run unit tests that check collaboration with API, generate and publish a consumer-driven contract. For my practical case, I will use Pact implementation for JavaScript. The name of the NPM package is Pact Foundation Pact Web. I also need two additional packages to integrate Pact with Karma. The first is Karma Pact. It allows the Karma test runner to launch a Pact mock server before executing Pact tests on the browser. And the second is the Pact Node package that previous Karma Pact package depends on. I also will use the Pact node to publish a contract. Here what is Pact dependencies look like in the package JSON. And here how they look like in node models folder. Let's look at the Karma configuration file. First of all, we need to add Pact into frameworks and plugins to let Karma know that I will use Pact. The second, we need to set up Pact settings, like a port for the mock server, names of consumer and provider, and the folder where Pact will save a generated contract. The third important thing is the proxy section. During the test process, we need to redirect API requests to a mock server that is running on a local machine. In this folder, we see services that implement collaboration with the provider via REST API. Every service has two spec files, because I prefer to keep Pact tests separate from regular unit tests. Look into the auth service class. It has four methods: login, logout, sign up, and verify user email with token. API has to have a corresponding endpoint for every method, and auth service has expectation regarding API endpoints parameters like path, HTTP method, format of request and response. These expectations will be formulated and verified in the auth service Pact test suite. The Pact test suites have the same structure as regular Jasmine test suites. We see parent describe function Pact with auth API that wrap four describe functions, one for each method of auth service. To bring Pact functionality into the test suite, we need to import a provider. Provider initialization is pretty straightforward, but give us a main idea that the provider will play a role of mock server to handle interactions. The second purpose of the provider is generating a contract after the test is complete. This happens during finalize call in after all function. Let's consider the login unit test case. In the Jasmine before function, we are creating an interaction object. This object will supply mock server information about a pair of expected requests and predefined response. When the test will be passed, Pact also will use interaction properties to generate a contract file. Interaction object has fields with request and will respond with, which contain information about expected request and prepared response. Upon receiving, it's just a meaningful description of request and doesn't have a real effect on testing flow. The state field keeps an important unique string identifier of state. This allows to provider prepare a special state before perform testing on its site. The unit test looks very straightforward. We pass email and password to the login method and check that we don't have errors and we have an expected response. The login method just creates a request to the API and returns back the obtained result. Since the mock provider is waiting for this request, it will return back a predefined result. And this result is in fact the same object that we use in the expect statement. This construction looks so simple and obvious that it can make you confused. Take a quick look at another example from official Pact GitHub. Here is a test data doc example and expected body that contains this test data. Here we set up a mock server to return this data with a response. And here we verify that returned data is equal expected data, which in fact are the same. The key for understanding this simplicity can be found in this scheme. The scope of CDC testing on the consumer side is very narrow and focuses on verifying the interaction between collaborator, in our case, of service, and external service, in our case, REST API endpoint. To be sure that interaction is okay, we need to formalize requirements to the endpoint and put them in a contract. We can say that this formalization and fixation of requirements is the main purpose of the test. On this general scheme, we see that interaction supplies the mock server with a minimal expected response. The minimal expected response means that we have to worry only about type and structure of data, but not about precise values. For example, if the expected response has to be an array of strings, the length of the array and practical values of strings are not important. This is because Pact follows Postel's law, also known as robustness principle. Be conservative in what you send, be liberal in what you accept. Let's look at what minimal expected response means from a technical perspective. We set up interaction with exact values of email and password for request, but we use a like function in response. This means that we return the body with something like login response, but not exactly. Only the type of object is important. Here is another example where I use each like for array in combination with term and like functions to describe the type of objects in the array. Functions each like, term, and like are so-called matchers that we need to import from Pact Web library. What the matchers are doing in a nutshell. They don't modify test data that will be used in a mock server for response. So, if we use the like function with login response here, during the test, we will get back in response login response object without any modification. But matchers add some kind of metadata to the contract. This is how it looks in the JSON contract file. This information will be used by Pact test to verify provider response. Check types instead of strict comparison of values to follow Postel's law. The Pact test execute in regular test flow. To run them, we can use the common Angular CLI command ng-test. The only difference that we can see here in logs is that the Karma test runner builds up the Pact mock server. We can reach out to the mock server via browser. Just put localhost 1234 in URL. We get a message, no interaction found, and this makes sense because the mock server doesn't have any prepared interaction for this URL. After all tests, one time we need to call the finalize method on the provider. It will clear any interactions left behind and write a Pact contract into a JSON file. The JSON will be created in a place that was pointed to in the Karma config file. For me, it's a Pacts folder. The name of the contract file is the names of consumer and provider. This is JSON with description of expected requests and responses between consumer and provider. All this information is generated based on the interaction objects that we used in the unit tests. To make a contract available outside of the current codebase, we need to publish it. This script imports a Pact object from Pact Node library. Set up some parameters related with Pact broker, JSON file location and version of contract, and after perform publishing. We can run this script with the command. And we see that the contract was published successfully. I'm using the Pact Flow project for hosting my contracts. And here is a contract that I just published. The web interface of Pact Flow allows developers to check the statuses of interaction verifications and have access to details of contracts. The Pact Flow is a collaboration tool that helps to share contracts between different codebases and teams. And in my practical example, I use it to share contracts between my client web interface and server side of application. In this video, we considered CDC testing on the consumer side with Pact, Karma, and Jasmine. We set up interaction for a mock provider service to run unit tests, generated and published a contract JSON file that contains consumer expectations regarding collaboration with the provider. And in the next video, I'll show you how to use this contract for provider testing.